Namaskaram, Bhagavad Gita, 2nd chapter, Sloka 61. In this Sloka, Lord Krishna continues explaining about the qualities of Stitha Prajna, one who is steady-minded. So he says, one who is in perfect knowledge, he subdues his senses and keeps his mind ever absorbed in me. So here he is emphasizing on absorption in devotion. The mind, that absorption devotion is towards Lord Krishna. Mind and senses have to be tamed. How can they be tamed? Only by keeping God in our mind. That is what absorption in devotion towards God. And we should always think of God. He should be in our thoughts so that the mind is controlled. In Bhagavata Puranam, a good example of this kind of soul is given. He was King Ambarish. King Ambarish kept his senses under control and he always kept his mind in remembering the golden feet of Bhagavan, and his tongue was used to only chant the names of God, ears to hear the narration about the past times of God, the qualities, divine qualities of God, in eyes to see the deity in the temple, and touch, the sense of touch. It was used only to massage the feet of the devotees of God. And the nostrils to feel the aroma from the fragranted objects which had been offered to God. So after offering, the nostrils smell the aroma. So only for that it is there. Then feet to pradakshana, go around the temple. Then head, bow down to God and his devotees. So he engaged all his senses only in the service to God. So he's a role model for us. It's a beautiful character given, described in Bhagavata Puranam. In next sloka, how can we control mind? How can we keep the thoughts of God in our mind? Because there are so many other thoughts going on. What shall we do with those thoughts? When you contemplate on anything, your mind will be thinking only about it. So here God says how to remove the thoughts which are not good for us. So when you see an object and you contemplate on that, then your mind is attached to that object, then it leads to desire. This happens to us because when you go to shop, we get attracted by, it can be a sari, or it can be a jewelry, or it can be a gadget, or it can be anything. But we are attracted towards the objects. And the thought of that object comes to our mind repeatedly. That leads to desire. We want to get it. The thought makes us to get it at any cost. So what happens? If you don't get it, it leads to anger. If you get it, it makes us buy something else again. So we keep on buying. So it leads to greediness. So the desire leads to greediness and anger. All these have to be removed. They are anger, greediness, lust. They are all considered as diseases by Vedic literature. So you have to remove them. How to identify them first? When you have any physical problem, that is when you are physical body is aching, any part of our body is aching, we can feel it and we can see it, that hand is paining or leg is paining. But when the problems go on, when the ailments go on in our mind, but there are multiple mental ailments, we do not understand that. So what happens? We ignore it. So that leads to anger and other negative qualities. So how to stop them from getting into our mind? That is what Lord Krishna says. So don't get attached to any object. And we feel that only that gives happiness. So you find out which is true happiness. What gives you true happiness? It can be only the thought of God, nothing else. So understand that. To understand that, we have to read scriptures. We have to listen to the elders. So that is very important. So he says that. So when you are attached to something, you get desire and you get greediness, anger, and when desire is not fulfilled, that leads to all problems, all negative qualities and actions. So desire is a cause of misery. So it should be definitely renounced. So God says, no, don't have it. If you have it, please give up. So here he is advising Arjuna. So get up, remove all that, understand your duty and get ready for war. So he is clarifying his doubts. How a jnani is able to live with content and mind? Why he is not focusing on wants? He needs only what is required for survival. He's not going after the objects. So let us not do that. So this advice is for us, because we like to, we easily get influenced. That is a weakness of ourselves. So how to come up from it? How to convert it to strength? Only by following the divine path, only by being a devotee of God and absorb yourselves in God, then you have a good intellect. So this is what Lord Krishna says. So in the next sloka, he continues and he says, when your intellect clouded, what happens? You are not able to control your anger, because intellect wants us. So in the previous sloka we learnt how intellect controls mind. So when we go out, especially in workplace, how we are bound by rules, how we follow rules. The intellect tells the mind, no, you have to follow this rule. If you don't obey your job, you will be losing your job. If you lose job, you lose your income. If you lose your income, your life is at risk. I mean, you will be feeling sorry for it. So the intellect wants the mind. But here the intellect is clouded by desires, anger, greediness. So what happens? There's nothing to warn us, to create alertness in us. So that anger leads to a bewilderment of memory. Intellect gets destroyed, that makes one gets ruined. This is how we see in many Puranas, how even rishis, they get anger and how they are affected by that. And kings, we have seen. And in daily life, you come across in the newspaper and other sources of news, we find how people kill each other, their relatives, the friends, whoever the person is, because of greediness. They don't even realize that they are their near and dear ones. But they kill them and get the property. But they don't, because they are arrested. So they are not enjoying that. But they make a sin. So how to protect themselves from that stage. Only by allowing the intellect to get good knowledge. So this is what Lord Krishna says. So once intellect is ruined, the person is, that's so, the person is ruined. So it is, his life will be miserable. So he is showing us how to get a good path, how to have good thoughts, good actions, and how to get that intellect, how to get knowledge. So these three slokas help us to lead a very disciplined life, a peaceful life. And one of the Alvars, Thirupan Alvar, he says in one of the Pasurams, Andarkon Aniyarangane en Amudanai Kanda Kangal Matondrinai Kanave. This is, he lived as a role model for us. He completely engaged all his senses only towards God. He thought of Ranga always, Ranganatha. He sang songs only on Ranganatha. He heard only about Ranganatha. So only Ranganatha was in his mind. And God made him come to his place. And he got, Thirupan Alvar got absorbed in God. So this is the reward for keeping all the senses under control. And we find many pasurams sung by the Alvars show the, when we read Gita, Bhagavad Gita, Krishna tells us how to live. And when you read the pasurams tell us how to be, how to make it possible in our life. So this is what we learn from all these pasurams. And Kulashekarva Alvar, how he gave up all his wealth and he became, he became Alvar, that is, he gave up all his wealth and he went to many temples and he went to have darshan of God in all the Divya Deshams, and he sang many pasurams. So for that, he gave up everything. That is the most important thing. So that is why he came to that position of giving up his enormous wealth, and he decided to lead a very normal life. So his pasuram says, Marandegal mana morindu vanja matri aim pulangal, that is five senses, adakki idarpara thunbam turandu irumu podu deti ella illada thunnerikkan nilai nindra thondarana. This is pasuram. In this pasuram he explains how Sri Vaishnava devotees, they do not have the bad thoughts of killing someone, getting anger or torturing someone or abusing someone. They never have all this in their mind. And they control their senses by keeping their senses only towards God and surrendering themselves to God, Sriman Narayanan. And they always in thoughts of Sriman Narayanan, such people are protected by Sriman Narayana. This is what Kulashekar Alvar explains in this pasuram. So the pasurams and Gita make our life go smoothly and in a very disciplined way.